my secret weapons on this new syndicate this season is I've been soaking my baits in the L030. I mean, what I do, obviously, I just have it in a little clear jar, so if anybody comes round, it doesn't look anything, you know. Not only that, you can't put them in the tub. And, yeah, obviously, the L030, there's a load of krill in there, but it's full of salt. And they've not actually spawned on this pit yet because it's really deep, and they're absolutely crying out for salt in their diet, so the more salt you can get into the bait, the better. So, yeah, that seems to be working really well at the moment. That's the only drawback with this, having to put your hands in the pot. Full on, proper, messy job. But, really is worth it. The other thing I've been doing as well, don't know whether Jace will tell me off at DNA, but I've actually been putting some dissolved salt in the L030. I mean, it's full of salt anyway, but like I said, the crave for salt this time of year. Something that Mark Holmes always bangs on about, a man with a massive amount of experience for catching big fish. I mean, I don't know in terms of the salt and everything. I'm sure if he was on a small water and everybody was smashing salt in, I don't know whether it could change the pH of the water, which you'd expect it to if there was a lot, but I just use it in tiny amounts, just fishing for single bites. So certainly what I'm doing, one nutted out right out there about 20 yards there, using the little PB bait stop as well, using double 14 mil baits. I love the little bait stops, a little bit of shrink tube there. I'm also using the ready-made aligner liner from PB. It's just absolutely doing the job on here without a shadow of a doubt. You know, you hear so many times people pushing products and saying things, but I think it is important to remember there's lots of products out there that are good products and they work and do the job. There's lots of products out there that are just being sold to catch the angler, you know, just to benefit the companies. So anything you ever hear me talk about, always, and people will always know this who know me, anything I talk about and recommend, they're products that really do work. I'm actually putting this rod into 30 foot of water. A lot of people are very shy about fishing in the deep. But what I do first, I put about 4 or 5 bits of foam in there. And then on top of the foam, I put a handful of pellets. And on top of the pellets, I put an even amount normally of boilies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Normally 6 to 8. Yeah, I like that foam in there. I've watched it drop through the water. It makes all the difference. It slows it right down in that deeper water going through. And also, you know, when you hit the bottom, you also know that if the foam comes straight up, because basically, when I've fished in a bit deeper water, there is deeper water on this lake, I've had to double bag it and stuff, but I've just found this is just about right. It's about the right amount. So you find as soon as it hits the bottom, you feel the lead donk down, and about 10 seconds later, the foam is on the way up, you know, and it gives me a lot of confidence because, you know, if that foam's on the way up, you know, if it's on the way up, it's all good. I mean, the thing is, at the end of the day, sometimes the foam don't come up and you start thinking to yourself, the foam doesn't come out of the bag and you think, oh, I don't know. You know, and there is the odd time, oh, another one just jumped right out there then. Yeah, there's the odd time where you go to retrieve it and obviously it's all snagged up in Canadian pondweed on the bottom. And that's the last thing, you don't want to be sat behind rods and not fishing effective. I've got that foam in there at the bottom, you can see that. So I actually pulled a hook into the foam and the pellet. So there's no way whatsoever you can get mast on a boilie. It's happened to me loads of times years and years ago. You know, you pull in the morning, well, I say loads of times, it only happens a few times and you sort of wise up, don't you? But yeah, you'd reel in the morning, you'd have a flipping boilie on the point of the hook. I mean, really, that is soul destroying, you know, when you're perhaps fishing and you're, you know, when you're working and you've got to go to work all day and you've just got that chance of a bite. So there I go, I just pull that. That's gone right into that foam at the back there. I'm going to do now, just put one of the anti-tangle sleeves on. I mean, this is the beauty of this little system that I'm fishing with, the quick release swivels. So basically, get all your rigs tied up, get all your bags done, all on your rigs. Bob's your uncle. And away you go. I mean, when you're fishing a pressured syndicate like this, it don't really matter, to be honest, because you have actually sometimes got all the time in the world. But there are times when you really do need to act quickly. And just slide that up. Job done. Right, I've got to do the old dip in with this, which, again, bit of a nasty old job. Somebody's got to do it. There you have it.